So it was an immediate death. Well, with potassium cyanide, I suppose that's possible. Yes, die pretty quick from that stuff. Oh yeah, he slumped over without so much as a twitch. I felt the Javachino I just drank turn sour in my stomach. Oh yes, I know that feeling. Where's his next cup? He's been sat on 5 for a while. Somebody get this man a coffee. And the waitress, I presume she is... That's the serving girl right there in the defendant's chair. Right. You said I remember her well in reference to the waitress. Did she have any particular features that you can identify her by? Besides her legs? Particular features? It's a disgrace, that's what it is. Sorry. You can see all the way up to her... you know. He's practically naked in that uniform. So the particular feature you recognize about the waitress is her outfit. No, I think it's just a little bit below that phoenix. Yeah, that butt. But anyone could wear such a uniform, even me. No. No, that's in my head now. Thank you. That's never leaving. Never going away. Oh. Mr. Wright, please spare the court any further mental anguish from that image. Thank you, Judge. For once, I'm with you. Don't get all excited, Nick. You've got to keep yourself together. I guess I got a bit carried away. Ha! There are other things I recognize about her, too. Seems pretty sure of himself. What should I do? Press? Press! Press it like a big red button. Sure, you saw the waitress take the coffee over to the victim. But what matters is whether the waitress is Maggie Bird or not. Quite right. Mr. Kudo, these are the features that you recognize about the defendant. I would ask that you add them to your testimony. Sure, sure. There was a ribbon in her hair, and her apron straps were loose. Okay, she does have a ribbon in her hair. And her apron straps were loose. We don't really have anything that would... What would be interesting is if he testifies that her apron was clean. I'm nosy. Is the coffee cup there for the number of coffees Godot drinks? Yes. Yes, it is. Present her image? Yeah, the thing is, her image doesn't necessarily show the apron straps. It does show a bow in the hair, though. So that's true. I'm wondering if maybe it's going to be more the question of the apron being clean or not. I'd be very interested to know. Because if he says it was clean, hers was dirty. Let's press first and see what happens. You do seem to remember several details about her appearance, but what about the most crucial detail of all, her face? Like he looks at that. Ha, as if I would remember that.
Objection!
The witness noticed the straps on the accused apron. He's unlikely to make a mistake about her face.
Yeah, right.
That's right. I can even tell you the color of the ribbon in her hair. It was red. So you see, there's nothing wrong with the witness's eyesight.
Hmm.
No doubt he remembers the waitress pretty well. And I guess you could call it red. I mean, to me it's kind of a dark orange, but yeah. Yeah, exactly. It's red or orange. It's like, Then again, Godot wouldn't know what's red, would he? He didn't even know there was a red stain on this apron. He didn't know. He was like, what are you talking about, blood stain? There's no blood stain. There's no stain on there at all. And then it turned out it's ketchup anyway. And he's like, I didn't know that was there, because his visor's red. It's like, he can't see it. It's great. I loved that. Yeah. That was so funny. I just love that it turned out to not even be a big deal to begin with, you know? Alright. What should I do? I get the feeling there's something more to this somehow. Ask about the straps first. Mr. Kudo, you seem especially interested in straps. Why is that? A what? The ribbon in her hair, the strap on her apron. What's the fascination here? What kind of weird kink do you have? Oh, God. Because he liked to undo them. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Ugh. Fascination? Down the slippery slope we go. People have all kinds of fetishes. Try. He just literally calls it out like, dude, of course he's got a kink. Don't shame. We don't need to embarrass the witness. Listen, you young upstarts. I haven't got some sick strap fetish. Is there any relevance to the witness's unusual love of straps, Mr. Wright? I was just curious as to why he's so fixated on the waitress's straps. I said I haven't got a strap fetish. How many times do I have to repeat myself? At least once more. Very well, continue with your testimony, Mr. Kudo, and make it strapless. You think old Seedy really saw Maggie do it? Old Seedy, oh, that's a good one. I like that. He is a seedy old man. Very well done, Maya. Well, he probably had his eye on the waitress the whole time. That's why he was there. But he was there for the cute outfits, right? Not the waitress, I guess. She makes a good point, though. Hey, did I just say something clever? Yes. I wonder if the waitress Mr. Kudo saw really was Maggie. That's what we have to figure out, Nick. Alright, let's go back to that and ask the other question about the back, if it will let us. Press. Remember the details, but what about the most crucial detail? Her face, blah 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 blah. Notice the straps is unlikely to make a problem with her face. Tell the color of the ribbon, it was red. Godot's like, what's red? What should I do? Ask about the back. The identifying features you described are all things you would see from the back. So what? Is it possible that you never saw the waitress from the front at all? Huh. He's got you there, Gramps. Why did you object to say that? Maybe he has face blindness and only recognizes people by their accessories. Oh my god. Could you imagine that? As an actual thing? You just see, like, a void where the face would be. Or every time you look at the face, your eye just kind of slides away and you don't know. That would be something horrific. Ooh. The faceless ones. People normally talk about facial features when they're asked to describe someone. But this witness's testimony is nothing but straps and ribbons. That is harassment! I tell you I'm not obsessed with straps or ribbons. Never said you were. Again, just pointing that out. I think you doth protest too much, sir. I can't describe faces from memory. Yeah, I mean, I'm terrible at it. I've had to give police witness accounts in the past when I worked for the shop I worked for. I actually delivered to a customer's address with another colleague three television sets and a bunch of wall mounts and cables and stuff that they bought on a business account, which they then cancelled the checks for, thinking they were being cute, and got a bunch of free stuff and tried to run off with it. And I had to describe what the guys looked like from memory. It was hard. It is very hard to do. People with the face blindness still see faces. They just can't store them. They just can't store them associated with people's identities. Yeah, that's true. But yeah, it's really difficult to describe a face from memory. You know? And the guy asked me, the guy who was interviewing me, asked me to sort of just sit there, close my eyes, walk through the scene with him while he described what I'd said happened, and then said, now, tell me what does the guy look like? And it was weird. It was like, I kind of see him there. And I started just reeling off details. I'm like, yeah, short, cropped, black hair and, you know, a bit of grey in it and stuff like that. You know, just started reeling off physical descriptions. And then what was he wearing? What colour t-shirt was it? That kind of thing. So, yeah. And then I got a letter from the court saying that I might need to attend court in Manchester to give my description of the events on the stand, but they didn't think it was likely. And it turns out the guys pleaded guilty. So, nothing required. I was like, oh, thank God. I don't want to drive all the way to Manchester Crown Court. Fuck. And I've been on jury duty before as well. I have a lot of experience with the legal system on the good side of it, not the bad side. Although I did get pulled over once for running a red light and got a ticket. That sucked. That was bad. I didn't enjoy that. Mr. Kudo, the court requests that you add details about the identifying features. Features you observed from the front, that is, to your testimony. Sure, sure. This old man's testimony gets longer and longer. And if I can find a hole in it soon, it'll get even longer, I bet. Just like the trail of seed he leaves behind him, wherever he goes. There wasn't anything that caught my interest about her when I saw her from the front. Well, that's a cop-out! My only interaction with the legal system has been getting thrown out of Stockholm Central Station for being too drunk. What? Zaras? Dude, I can't imagine you in that state, to be honest. You're always so chilled and... I don't know. We've had drinks together, but I've never seen you be like that. My goodness. Damn traffic nerds. Yeah. You didn't find anything to be distinct, but you did clearly see the witness's face, yes? No question about it. I didn't come this far to back down now. Victor Kudo never backs down. That's not the answer I was looking for, but okay. This has turned into a matter of pride for old Seedy now, I guess. I wonder if he really did see Maggie's face or not. Like I thought, we need some concrete proof of this. Proof that the old guy didn't see the waitress clearly from the front. Do you think old Seedy really saw Maggie do it? Well, he probably had his eye on the waitress the whole time. That's why he was there. But he was there for the cute outfits, I guess. Blah, blah, blah. We've already done this. Make a good point. Never had issues with the police, but your brother has over someone stalking his ex-girlfriend. Ooh, damn. Nasty. So how do we point out that he didn't see her from behind? From the front, sorry. See, he's not been added to the plan yet. So the young man was reading the sports paper, which we have. The serving girl brought him a Java Chino and put something in it. No question, very conspicuous, put white powder in there from that brown bottle. The man took one sip of it, looked like he was in terrible pain and collapsed. The serving girl right there in the defendant's chair, I remember her well. A ribbon in her hair, apron straps were loose. There wasn't anything that caught my interest about her when I saw her from the front. Let's press this again and see what it said. They spoofed his email, so the police thought he'd sent all the emails. Ooh, dear. Right, yeah, that sounds messy. And the ex dropped to the investigation, though we never knew who was the culprit. That is some creepy shit. That's somebody just trying to get your brother in trouble, isn't it? That's shit. Why do people do shit like that? I don't know. Maybe we just can't let shit rest. You didn't find anything distinct. You clearly remember the face. No question about it. Didn't come this far to back down. Any proof he didn't see her clearly from the front? I wonder if maybe... somebody else walked in, dressed as a waitress, poisoned the coffee, and then went. That would be interesting. An accomplice. But Maggie did say she brought the coffee. So it's got to be Maggie, right? It can't not be. She said that this guy brought... that she brought coffee to the victim. Only thing he was reading up on Ace Attorney cases when it started, and you were like, fuck.
Yeah.
I mean, what if he said that she didn't have glasses on or something? That's the kind of thing we need to know, right? She didn't have glasses. And then we can nail him. But how do we bring this out? How do we get this moving? A ribbon in her hair and her apron straps were loose. So weird of a detail. Why would they be loose? You know? Why would they be loose? Wasn't anything that caught my interest about her when I saw her from the front. See if inspiration can strike us again like it did last time where we were talking our way through it and I was like, oh shit, the pill bag's empty, huh? So, we're looking for anything that is specifically about Maggie and nothing else. We've got a floor plan, but he doesn't remember where he was sitting. We need to pin him down on where he was sitting. But he literally says, you know, he doesn't care, he doesn't know where he sat. And if he saw the victim clearly, well, Phoenix said he would have to be in this bottom right corner one in order to see the events clearly, because the others have partitions that would have obscured his view. He's either looking in the wrong direction or he's looking past a partition, and he wouldn't know if there was someone else in the top right table's left-hand chair, which is that way, sorry. Webcam's reversed. So if that's the case, we need to pin him down on that. The direction of him seeing only from the back must mean when the waitress came out of the kitchen with a coffee, he had to be sitting facing the front. That-a-way. Yeah. He had to be facing this way. So he could have only been sat in a chair with his back to the kitchen. See the waitress come out and see from behind. And then maybe the waitress left. Went to the front and then left. It was a bogus waitress bringing a poison coffee cup. Because the thing is as well, there's a coffee stain on the table where the victim spilled his coffee after drinking from it. But there's also one on the apron. Did she spill the first coffee when she brought it and forgot to tell us? You never know. How would Maggie not know another waitress was in there running around? She's not told us a lot of things, though. But anyway, there's that. The crime scene photo taken from the direction of the kitchen, which is what the owner probably took. We don't know who took this, but we're imagining it's the owner. That was his view. Shows that they can see the other chair and nobody was in it. The coffee cup. So, that has Maggie's fingerprints on it, and it's also got the cyanide in. So, Maggie must have been the one that delivered the poison coffee. It's kind of weird. I think maybe we need to pull apart the whole he saw her sprinkling the shit in it. I don't know. That's the winning ticket, found her in a search of Maggie. That's her apron from the time of the incident with coffee stain and ketchup on it. And that's it. There's nothing else to do with Maggie. And he even identified the brown bottle after Godot and helpfully just held up and said, is this the bottle you saw? Like, of course he's gonna say yes. Get him to describe the bottle and see if it matches what you have. But anyway. Maggie, a waitress at Très Bien, was found guilty of murder thanks to the phony me. She does have a ribbon in her hair. Her apron straps will lose such a weird detail. So how do we challenge this? There wasn't anything that caught my interest about her when we saw her from the front. So we had to fight to get this added. What else did we get added to the testimony? This one, no question about it, she very conspicuously put some white powder in there. You know what's also interesting to me? His posture changes on this one. And this one. Felix is all like, looking at us, no problem. He's looking around, no problem. Then suddenly he's like, ah, like he's very insistent. And all of those are normal postures again. No question about it, she conspicuously put some white powder in there. Let's press this again. So this is the other thing we had him add to the testimony. So either one of these two is the statement we need to challenge, but with what? Did she really put them in the coffee? No doubt, you doubt me, boy. She took out some small brown bottle and sprinkled it in. But she had been adding the sugar in a small brown bottle like that. We also know there was no sugar in the coffee, so that's silly. Like what? Could you please describe it? And then Godot's like, is it this? Dickhead. Oh, there it is, that's the one. The bottle of potassium cyanide, I presume. What did the accused put into the coffee? I think it's clear now, don't you? Arg. It's kind of irrefutable, though, isn't it? So it's this whole seeing her from behind thing. That must be the thing we have to challenge. Let's maybe press this again. You said I remember her well in reference to the waitress. Did she have any particular features you can identify her by? It's a disgrace, sorry, you conceal the way to her, you know, she's practically naked. The particular features you recognize is her outfit. But anyone could wear that, even me. Creepy, please don't do that. Other things I recognize too. A ribbon in her hair and her apron straps were loose. I remember the details of the appearance. Most crucial detail of all, her face, as if I would remember that. The witness noticed the straps on the accused apron. He's unlikely to make a mistake about her face, that's right. The face, we need to bring this about. Look at the photo again. Which one? You mean the crime scene photo? Nope, that's not it. That's the floor plan. The witness? You mean his profile picture? I don't know what you're trying to point me to. Oh, the waitress. So looking at her photo, right? I mean, she does have a ribbon in her hair. I mean, I guess we can press this against this statement and see. Was there another photo, or am I crazy? No, it's shown as pictures, but they're more like visualizations of the scene that he's describing. They're not actually photos that are evidence. It's shown as the picture of her from behind when he's talked about stuff. It'll probably pop up again in a moment. Yeah, sometimes they're like just descriptions of events, and it just gives you a visualization, which is kind of weird because it does make you think to yourself, how do I present that? But it's not actually a photo that is physical evidence. Nobody took that picture. He's describing it. Could tell you the colour of the ribbon, the hair, it was red. You see, there's nothing wrong with the witness's eyesight. It didn't bring it back up this time, though. Didn't find anything to be distinctly clearly see the witness's face, no question. Back down now. This has got to be the one we hit, but we don't know. He was there for the cute outfits, not the waitress's, right? I guess that's a good point. Okay, hang on then. So she's just said that. That was something clever that we have to point out. Maybe, just for science sake... Hey, Harakai! It's the hentai old man. Yes, this is Mr. Kudo, spreader of seed, as I call him. Or seedy old man, as Maya calls him. Baka! Baka hentai! I think I know what they're asking for. Yeah, I think I do as well. It's that what Maya's just said is a bit of a clue. If we read his description again, has a thing for waitresses. Maybe we point that out and say, I don't think you did see her face at all. You don't look at those. We spoke to you in the park earlier, and you literally admitted that you're there just for the ladies, to ogle them. So I'm going to try pushing, presenting that to him, about him. No. the game froze on me again. Yeah, no. Look at this statement. There wasn't anything that caught my interest about her when I saw her from the front. Well, I think it's going to be about glasses, right? He would probably say she wore glasses, because he's not remembering, like we say, the face, but he's remembering accessories, so why wouldn't he remember the glasses? Maybe we go with that. Maybe we don't. Oh, it's so obscure. Wasn't anything interesting caught when I saw from the front? Oh, I know. The apron itself is smothered in shit. It's got a whole lot of shots all over it. He would have noticed that shit, right? If he's looking at the apron and the uniform. And we get there eventually. I mean, eventually I would have just pushed everything against every statement and you will find it, you know, but yeah. Mr. Kudo, I would like you to please take a look at this. Ha, that filthy thing would suit filth like you just perfectly. Actually, it reminds me of what my grandson looks like after he's done eating. Have you ever seen this before? Of course I haven't. You think I'd forget something as dirty as that, hmm? Well, oh god, you half-witted clot. What? What is it? Ever since I said you half-witted clot, there's been an eerie silence in here. Mr. Kudo, this apron is the apron worn by the defendant on the day of the poisoning. Ah? And as you just said yourself, you wouldn't forget something like this, which means if you had really seen this apron before... Yes, you know what I'm getting at. You couldn't have possibly seen the waitress from the front. Oops. Damn right, oops. Get wrecked. You can't just oops your way out of this. Huh, well, well. Looks like we finally have a genuine trial on our hands. There it is! Coffee number 6. Oh yes, he's back. Listen, Trite, here are the facts. On the day of the incident, there was only one witness in the restaurant. That being the defendant, Ms. Maggie Bird. Exactly. A one waitress. When that one waitress put the poison into the coffee cup, this old guy was watching. I hope you understand the gravity of the situation, Mr. Kudo. The fate of the defendant may rest on what you say you remember seeing. Just tell the court exactly what you saw, Gramps. You can rely on me, Captain. My noggin is in perfect working order. I can't remember a single occasion when I forgot what burger a customer wanted. Well, here's the thing with that statement. If you actually forgot what order they had, you wouldn't actually be remembering it, would you? You don't remember things you forgot anyway, dummy. He can't remember, probably like he messed up so many times he's blocking it out. Yeah, you don't, you know, remember things that you forgot. That's the point, you forgot them. Very well, let's test just how good your memory and attention to detail is, Mr. Kudo. Tell us what you remember about the victim. Here we come to the spicy bits. He was another of those pesky young types wearing a broken pair of spectacles. He had a newspaper in his right hand and the noisy brat kept rustling its pages. The young man was listening to the wireless, I remember it well. Then the serving girl in question brought over the Javachino. The little fidget picked up his cup with his free hand and took a sip. Okay. Okay, the testimony we've just heard was to test how credible the witness's memory is. It seems to me that he remembers the victim in a great deal of detail. Oh yes, I hate those you-know-what types who are so vague about everything. Okay, how are we going to handle this, Nick? We only need to do one thing. We just need to prove the old man's memory is shot. Just trip him up, you mean? Isn't that kind of cruel? Don't tempt me. I'm thinking physically now. Maybe we could. Find a good flight of stairs and just... No, that would be wrong. I suppose, but it's what I do best. Phoenix, tripper of old men. Another of the pesky young types wearing a broken pair of spectacles. I love that. Spectacles? Dark glasses to you. One of the lenses was green, the other was broken. Newfangled rubbish, that's why I remember him so well. That's because he's wearing one of these visors, but there isn't another one there. It's one-sided only, right? So, maybe that needs to be tweaked a bit. He did have some kind of lens over his left eye, but I wouldn't have called it a pair of glasses. He seems to have been wearing some rather modern-looking shades. Or a shade. Half of a shade. A sha. Perhaps I should take to wearing some and rival Mr. Godot's sharp appearance. Ah, we'd better come up with something sharp and quick. I guess I'll wait and see if I should challenge him about the spectacles. He had a newspaper in his hand. The newspaper was a sports paper, was it? That young hooligan, I nearly asked him, can't you even read without fidgeting, hmm? How was I supposed to be able to read the back page with all that rustling going on? I needed to find out if Gutzon Braun retained his championship title. You could have just asked. It was his paper, not yours. If you wanted to know so bad, why didn't you buy your own? Or just ask him, excuse me, dude, is that the latest sports page? Could you just tell me something real quick? Have a look. Cheers, mate. What are you looking at me like that for? Oh god, ah, ow, ow! Stop spreading your seed all over me! Gutzon Braun got beaten yesterday, by the way. Anyway. The young man was listening to the wireless, I remember it well. Okay, hang on. I pushed the wrong button. What? He was spreading his seed all over me. He needs to stop that. This is a court. We don't do that kind of thing here. The wireless. The decadent young rascal. In my day, it was one or the other. Read the paper or listen to the wireless. Oh boy. And using an earpiece, it's selfish. That's what it is. I was straining my ears, but I couldn't catch any of it. Ooh, hydrate. Thank you. You got my back, dude. Thank you very much. He was that desperate to listen to the radio? What are you looking at me like that for? How dare you? Ah, he's spreading his seed again. Stop it. The serving girl in question brought the Javacino. You mean the waitress, who you only saw from behind, right? You're one of those, aren't you? You never let anything go, isn't that right? Maybe. That does it! I have enough fucking... Ah, fucking hell. God, I'm getting covered in seed today. This is wrong. Better not push until I've got some hard evidence. Picked up his cup with his free hand. I'm gonna get covered in seed every time I ask this guy a question, aren't I? His free hand? Yes. Which hand was that? When you were listening before, cloth ears, I said he was rustling the newspaper with his right hand, didn't I? If it was free hand was his right hand, then which hand is it, you moron? Oh, ow, ow, ow! Shut up, Godot. Perhaps the great Mr. Trite has three hands. Maybe I do. Yusha was only asking. No need to gang up on me and treat me like a freak. The whole point of this cross-examination is to establish just one thing. That this old guy's memory has more holes than a slice of Swiss. I guess we just need to find a contradiction in the testimony somewhere. Anything will do, even the smallest detail. We just need one mistake and he's ours. So, a young type with a pair of broken spectacles, newspaper in his right hand, and they kept rustling the pages, listening to the wireless, and remembers it well. Serving girl brought over the Javacino, and he picked up the coffee with his free hand and took a sip. So the way the cup is presented there, when you look at it, it looks almost like he was holding the cup with his right hand, not his left. That's the hand that's outstretched further to where the cup is. And the actual handle for the cup isn't in sight on this side, which would be for the left hand, which is how it would have fallen if it was there. Maybe that's the contradictory evidence. Maybe it's not. The everything else is kind of ironclad. Or just a little too vague to pull up as a slipped fact. He was wearing broken spectacles. Well, I mean, he's right. He just, you know, he's too cantankerous and old to know what those are. He thinks that they're broken glasses. He doesn't see a lens over the other eye because one of them's coloured and the other one isn't. And he's like, oh, the other one had a broken lens or a missing piece. So that's not really a lie. That's not that's not like a memory problem. That's just his reckoning up of events. He had a newspaper in his right hand. So he's very specific there. The right hand. The young man was listening to the wireless. Can't prove he wasn't either way. In fact, we know he was. That's true. The serving girl brought over the Javacino. Again. Can't dispute that. Then he picked up the coffee with his free hand. He's not very specific here. But he does remember he said right hand. But is he remembering the right hand correctly? So do we press on that one, or do we press on the one where he specifically says right hand? Probably that, right? Let me just read what the press was again. The newspaper was a sports paper. Right, so we're just obsessing over the paper. Are we supposed to read the back page? If Guts and Braun retain this championship title, we get smothered in seed. Mother. He got beaten yesterday. Let's see what the other one says. It's free hand. Which hand was that? Weren't you listening before, cloth ears? I said he was rustling the newspaper with his right hand. His free hand wasn't. The other hand, blah, blah, blah. Godot's loving this. Alright. Is there anything else that we can use? It's got to be something to do with the coffee cup. Oh, hang on, hang on, hang on, hang on, hang on. We've even got the cup with the lip stain on it. What the hell am I thinking? Yeah, look at it. You would have had to hold that with your right hand, because the handle's on the right-hand side, right? We use that, not the... because the photo was just a little bit too off. We use that. Oh yeah, I'm happy now. Mr. Kudo, do you remember what you told the start of the testimony? That this was a way of testing the credibility of your memory. I know, there's nothing wrong with my memory, I tell you. Nothing. If I got anything wrong, I'll eat these seeds and sing the pigeon song. Oh, please do. Yeah. Care to tell us where this is going, Trite? According to Mr. Kudo, the victim was holding the paper in his right hand, while drinking coffee with his free hand, which would make it his left. Ka! What is this? Kindergarten? But I would like the court to please take a look at this. That's the cup the victim used, correct? Yes, and on the rim you'll notice the mark left by the victim's lips. Yes, there's a stain left by the coffee. If you consider where that stain is, you'll clearly see that the victim was holding the cup in his right hand. But how? Well, Mr. Kudo, the court is waiting for your epic performance. Give us a song. You said you'd eat those seeds and sing the pigeon song. Ah! Mr. Kudo, I'm afraid this is simply not acceptable. I think the witness had better go back to the parkway. Wait! If you think I'm going to stand here and listen to you tell me I'm mad, you're wrong. I don't care about that dirty coffee cup. I know what I saw. You still insist on your testimony. That young brat was holding the cup in his left hand. Oh yes, no question. I'm a good law-abiding citizen, I am. It's that dead young hotbot and you spiky-head Yazoo who are at fault. Who, me? He saw it in the mirror. Good point. If he's so adamant, I was just thinking, so maybe he did, but how would he get it wrong? Saw it in a mirror. So... I remember there being a mirror on the wall somewhere. And I'm pretty sure it was on the back wall along the kitchen, wasn't it? This whole thing is far-fetched, yeah. But you're right, there was a mirror on the back wall. You see where it says kitchen? If you look at the wall that's just to the right of it, where the chair is, there is a mirror up there, if I remember correctly. Which means he had to be sitting facing the mirror. And not with a view of the actual guy. So that means he was sitting in the bottom left booth in the right hand seat. Or he was sitting in the top left in the right hand seat. Just wait and see how this unfolds. Mm-hmm. Thank you, old man. We've heard quite enough from you already. Don't call me old man, old man. Been around for 68 years, I have. Can't ignore me. Listen to what I've got to say. I'm sorry, Mr. Kudo, but... sure, why not hear a little more? Mr. Godot? But this is my 16th cup of coffee. Lies, where are the other 10? We know you've only had 6. I've been counting. Oh, this is another wild goose chase. Sorry, also forgot what I'm supposed to give. Not supposed to give hints. No, it's fine. Godot is a liar. Yeah, probably. I mean, it could be one or the other, but it could be a mirror or it could be a liar. But this is your final stand. Thank you, Captain. You can rely on Victor. Left hand or right hand? I know, right? We counted. He had 6 cups. I'm only counting when a cup slides in, though. So maybe sometimes when he just has a cup, it's a fresh one that we've not been counting. Contradiction. The boy was wearing the earpiece on the same side as the green lens of his specs. He kept fiddling with it all the time. He was fiddling with it just before he picked up the cup too, and then he used the same hand to pick up the cup, his left hand. We know the victim was wearing an unusual monocle over his left eye. It wasn't a monocle, Your Honor. It was a small computer monitor often used by programmers. A monitor? You mean like a television screen? The inside of the lens is a screen that displays computer data. It's called a HMD. It's a common tool in the victim's line of work. HDTV, DVD, CD. All these newfangled letters drive me mad, but they don't matter. I know what I saw, and I'm telling the truth. It's true, he does seem to be lying. And those are the facts in the good old black and white. Alright, so let's just look at this. Hang on. So, he was wearing the earpiece on the same side as the green lens. He kept fiddling with it all the time. Fiddling with it just before he picked up the cup too, and he used the same hand to pick up the cup as his left hand. So he's saying that the earpiece was in his left ear, and he did use his left hand. That's how he knows. Well, I mean, the earpiece being in the same portion as the lens, that is the left eye. So he's saying that because he saw him fiddling with his left earpiece, he then used that hand to pick up the cup, all in like a short space of motion. BRB, smell food? Mmm. Enjoy. Let's just press and see what happens. Let's see what shakes loose. So the victim was wearing a HMD. HDTV, CD, blah blah blah. What does it matter? It was none of them, actually, but anyway. And you're sure he was wearing the earpiece on the same side? No question, I could only see that side of his head from where I was sitting. So that means he was sitting along the bottom portion of the restaurant. That's pretty obvious if you look at the floor plan. From the opposite table, he'd only have a view of the side of the victim's head. Kept fiddling with it all the time. He was fiddling with it just before he picked the cup up too. Okay. It seems you keep an eye on, you kept an eye on Mr. Glenn Elog. He was getting on my nerves, rustling that newspaper and fiddling with his earpiece all the time. And then he went and made a fuss, dying from one sip of a Java Chino. I wanted to say to him, calm down, you young brat. Just looking at him made me suddenly speed up my seed eating. I could have choked. Gotta slow down when you're eating that seed, old man. So I take it the victim was a walking ball of nervous energy. Thing is though, this guy's going on about a guy who was fidgeting, but he's forever frigging bopping his own nose. Like, seriously, dude. Fiddling just before he picked up his cup. The earpiece you mentioned, which hand did the victim touch it with? You're one of those people, aren't you? The type that uses your left hand to get things out of your pocket, right? Only if it's in my left pocket, yes. Or fastens your left cuff with your right hand. Yes, because, you know, I can't dislocate my wrist. And when the tour guide says, on your right side, you'll see the famous blah blah blah, you're the only one who deliberately looks left, well, aren't you? No. I didn't mean... Obviously, he used the hand on the same side of his body that the earpiece was in. Ow, 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 ow! So if he had the HMD on his left side, then I guess it was his left hand. And then he used the same hand to pick up the cup, his left hand. You seem very sure of yourself, Mr. Kudo. That's because I know what I saw, no matter what tricks you try to play on me. Looks like he really did see the guy picking the cup up with his left hand. This is a dead end. Well, Nick, what do you think? think the guy's telling the truth. But even so, something's not quite right. It's very left, in fact. Sorry. Then chuck evidence at him until he breaks. Yes, what's the heaviest piece of evidence we've got? But if he's not lying, then there wouldn't be any contradictions in his testimony, right? Well, I mean, the picture shows he'd had that. But what about the crime scene picture? We can't actually see his visor there, or an earpiece for that matter of fact. Fiddling with it, well, fiddling just before he picked up the cup too, and he used the same hand to pick up the cup, his left hand. I mean, what if he didn't pick it up with the handle? What if he just grabbed the cup? Handle could have been around the other side. Okay, I forgot this got amended. Left eardrum is ruptured because he got ear medicine, right? He was wearing the earpiece on the same side of the green lens of his specs. That's bullshit. He wouldn't be wearing it on the ear. They had ruptured his eardrum. He wouldn't be able to hear shit. In fact, his ear medicine was in there. He was fiddling with his ear because of the ear medicine, probably. It might have been itching, or maybe he was applying it when this guy saw him. Objection! Oh yeah. Yeah! There we go. I'm not sure what the relevance of this is, but... Mr. Kudo, there's something very strange about your observation of the victim. What? You say he was wearing the earpiece on the same side as the HMD. No question, you can lock me up if I'm wrong. It was his left ear, without a doubt. I could only see that side of his head from where I was sitting. I don't think so. What did you say? You're no doubt unaware of this fact, Mr. Kudo, but the victim couldn't hear with his left ear. His eardrum was ruptured. Huh? Traces of medication for this condition were found in his ear canal. That's right, it's impossible that the victim was wearing his earpiece in his left ear, because he couldn't even hear in that ear. Is that true, Captain? It is. Pigeon! Pretty pigeon! Oh my god! Oh. Order! Order! That's enough pigeon song! Don't make me sing it. I will not. This witness's testimony is completely unreliable. He only saw the waitress from behind, and he claimed the victim was wearing an earpiece when we know his eardrum was ruptured. Well, Mr. Godot, a single drop of milk is all it takes to destroy the pure black magic in the cup. I'm with you on that, Godot. This old man, is my drop of milk. Freya with a large waste of points. Boom! Good stuff. Hope it brings you good fortune. Don't eat the feed, what the fuck? Captain, are you calling me a drip? Yes, the drippiest of drips that ever dripped into this courtroom from the faucet of life. This is the victim's coffee cup in which the potassium cyanide was found. The mark on the rim clearly shows the victim picked it up with his right hand. I'll never back down, I know I'm right. The lad drank his javacino with his left hand. Let me put you out of your misery. Clearly the victim used both hands. He took a sip of the cup with his right hand and then switched to his left. That's what the old man saw. No, because he took one sip and then died. The witness has already testified on numerous occasions the victim died immediately after taking just one sip of coffee. Here it is! Boom! Another cup. Which hand the victim used to pick up his cup is irrelevant, Your Honor. The fact still stands, with one hand or the other, Mr. Elg drank the poison coffee. But it discredits the witness. He's like... Sadly, Mr. Godot, that doesn't wash. The point of this testimony was to establish whether the witness's memory is credible, and the results are clear. This testimony given by this witness is useless. I believe it is time to conclude today's proceedings. I am satisfied that the witness is not deceiving the court, but to be frank, his testimony is a farce. And did you have to be so frank? Take that, you pompous old foggy! I'm sorry, Mr. Kudo. You can't reach me from there. I am mighty judge. I sit above you all. I am ordering the defense and the prosecution to investigate this case further. That is all for now. The court is adjourned. Wait! What? If we stop now, where does that leave me? Leave you, Mr. Kudo? Thanks to that blue-suited young upstart over there, I'm just a bumbling old man who can't even dot his T's or cross his own I's now. Yes. How is your bad memory my fault? I'm sorry, Mr. Kudo, but there's nothing I can do. You can just carry on, you just crack on with your day. Go into the world. Live your best life. I've kept my mouth shut until now, but there's something else the court should know. What? Or? To be perfectly honest, it might not be anything. But I want another chance. I want another crack at you, you young shark. Me? He's looking at me like I'm some sort of evil shogun. Well, everyone, what do you say to one final showdown? The final chapter in this eccentric old man's scrapbook. Sorry, Gramps. I've already had my 17th cup of coffee. Again, where's the other 10? What have you got to lose, Captain? I'll give you all the javacino you want if you come to my house after the trial. I may be 68-year-old, but Victor Kudo is still a man. That's enough, witness. I believe it will be quicker for the court to just hear your testimony. You bet. Much, much quicker. I can't believe this is happening. You better get ready, youngster. You young whippersnapper. I get the picture. Just quit throwing those seeds at me, would you? I don't want your seed all over me. Stop it. I don't know where that seed's been. He's got to be using some sort of infinite ammo code with that box of seeds. Yeah. Cheat. Dude, totally using a memory hack. First of all, I want to stress that this might be nothing if I'm not sure of myself. The young boy slumped over the table as soon as he took one sip of his javacino. Well, the clumsy idiot upset the vase. He knocked it right over. Redeeming hydrates. Cheers. Mmm. Thank you, delicious water. Mmm. It broke, and the strip of cloth covering the table got completely soaked. Okay, this is absolute complete codswallop now. Well, how about that? Turn things upside down now, hmm? And? Is that all? Yes, that's all. I remember it perfectly. Hey, you're doubting me, eh? Again, you doubting a poor defenseless old man? No, we're not doubting you, Mr. Kudo, just the point of this. Do you get the feeling there's a question hanging on everyone's lips, Nick? Yeah, so what, probably? That's all I can think of, and I have to cross-examine this guy. You're a bird brain. That's why you... that's all you can think of. Very well. Mr. Wright, your final cross-examination, please. This is more about the guy just trying to prove himself right about something. It has nothing to do with the case. I want to stress this may be nothing. Well, hang on a minute. He said the vase got knocked over. We can see it right there! This old guy, can we just send him to the nut house now, please? Let's humor him though. The cop generally prefers if witnesses are sure of themselves, Mr. Kudo. Noisy brat. I'm warning you, I'm more savage than a macho man right now.
Oh yeah!
Excuse me. You won't beat me, blah blah blah. Fucking hell. Dude, he's chucking those seeds harder than ever. Better be careful. I'm gonna get knocked out by a stray seed. Come on, nail him! The young boy slumped over the table as soon as he took a sip. Fuck. Oh my god. He took a shit and slumped over the table. Ah. Okay, let's move on from that. The court has already heard the testimony, Mr. Kudo. I know that, I was just setting the mood. How else am I supposed to build up the suspense, hmm? The suspense? Yes, now what do you think? Should I work the audience a bit more? No, no, please continue, Mr. Kudo, as quickly as possible. Alright, now where was I? Ah, yes, the young boy slumped over the table and... Well, the clumsy idiot upset the vase, he knocked it right over. A vase, you say? Yes, there are vases on all the tables in that place. They're accidents waiting to happen, they're practically begging to be knocked over. They are thin and spindly looking. Well, he's right about there being vases, I do remember seeing them too. But... There was a vase on the table where I ate lunch there. And you saw the moment when the victim actually knocked over the vase? Well, it's hard to say, it's a bit unclear. How do you really define? Okay, I get it. I heard it break, and the sight of it is burned into my memory as clear as day. You heard it break. And a strip of cloth got completely soaked. Soaked in water, you mean? Yes, it splashed me on the knee as well. You said you were sitting at the table across the room from the victim, correct? And yet, the water still managed to splash onto you? It was cold. I clearly remember it splashing me. Could the water really make it all the way across to the other side of the room? Or maybe something else splashed him. Well, what about that? Turn things upside down now, hmm? You mean the vase on the victim's table falling upside down and breaking? The vase turned upside down and my testimony is turning this case upside down. It's a joke. I just wanted everyone to hear it. What do you think, Captain? I'm impressed by your ability to waste time. Kudo hasn't raised any objections for a while now. So, you young show-off, with that scrap of information, I'm throwing down the gauntlet. If I lose this one, I'll take it like a man and admit defeat. He's really giving you the evil eye, Maya. He's looking at you, Nick, not me. It's like he's saying, I triple dog dare you to find the contradiction, young'un. Guess I just have to rise to the challenge. Probably gonna be this one that we have to get right, but you know, seriously, dude. Mr. Kudo, this is a photograph of the crime scene. Hmm? So what? Look carefully at the table. The vase is there intact. Huh? Lost your tongue, Granddad? I'm no granddad of yours, you hopscotch. Ow. I've never been called a hopscotch before. What the hell? Enough. If you throw any more seeds in this courtroom, the cleaners will be here all night. Ah! I've got better things to do than clean up your seed, Grandpa. What is it now? I just remembered something. Oh, fuck. Bugger off and let me take my break already. Yes, go on. A broken vase? It was on my table. For the second time today, you get a sad trombone. What? Oh, well, you see. It startled me when the young lad collapsed, so I stood up. That must have been when it fell over. The vase on my table, I mean. The vase on your table. Yes, it was on my table. Yep, that's it. Let's get the face palms in chat. And that's how my groin came to be completely soaked. Yeah, if you say so. Sure. Oh, I wanted another cup of coffee to slide in then. I was ready. I was like, give me that coffee. Okay, can we be done now, Judge, please? Throw this old man away. Thank you, Mr. Kudo. You've certainly earned your kudos for today. I'd like to ask a question now. Have I been any use at all? Yes, you have. We've learned not to listen to a damn thing you say. Very useful, thank you. Perhaps that's something you should reflect on yourself, Mr. Kudo. Ah! Wait a minute! If that's the case, there's more I've got to say. No, you admitted defeat. Shut up, sit down. Oh yes, I remember. Bailiff, escort the witness out of the courtroom. Listen to me! Well, we seem to have been considerably sidetracked. No kidding. And I'm still not in a position to deliver a verdict. The defendant has not been positively identified as the waitress in question. Additionally, there are two disparities in the testimony we have heard thus far. The mark on the coffee cup and the victim supposedly drank from his left hand. And the earpiece which was inserted into the left ear out of which he couldn't hear. Wow, Nick. You did it! I therefore require both defense and prosecution to further investigate the facts. Wow, Freya, you jumped to that star and you got it. Nicely done. Baller. Yes, Your Honor. There's one more thing before I call today's session to an end. One more thing, Your Honor. The witness we just heard from. He's most insistent that his testimony should be of use, so he summarized it accordingly into this statement. It's not a haiku, is it? Okay. You may each have a copy if you wish. Whatever. The prosecution doesn't need props like that. But I was really mad, huh? Yeah, I would be too. Very well. Here you are then, Mr. Wright. There are three copies, my own, yours, and Mr. Godot's. Yes, Your Honor. When the incident occurred, I broke my vase at my seat. I'm sorry. Ah. Dude likes his haikus. That's not really a good one. I'm sorry. This isn't a piece of testimony. More like a five-year-old's apology. I'm sorry. What the heck are we supposed to do with three copies? Burn them for warmth when society collapses, maybe? I don't know. That is all. Court is adjourned. Well, guys. Oi. Pop that over there a minute. It's time for our first break.
Hey guys, welcome back.
Have them wraps. I actually don't have wraps today. I made a pasta salad with egg. I forgot to get a piece of chicken out for to cook today, so I was like, damn, what do I make real quick? So I boiled an egg, and mashed it up, you know, once it was boiled and peeled and everything. Threw in some parboiled spiral pasta, a little bit of pepper, like chopped peppers. Yeah, a little bit of mustard in there as well. Sweet corn and some pre-cooked garlic sausage. And a little bit of cheese, and just, you know, mixed it all around. Shoved it in a box. Mmm. Okay. Let's move on. I still have a little bit left, actually, because I had to run down and get it out of the fridge. I couldn't leave that up here. I needed to keep it in the fridge, so I have a tiny bit left. I will eat it. And some grapes as well. I didn't get to eat any of the grapes. So maybe we'll take another break in about an hour, see how it goes. Rather than going 2 hours, I can finish eating. So how do you think the trial went this morning? How do you think it went? It got a bit crazy in there. I just wonder if that killed our chances. Yeah, I guess I did get out of, Mr. Kudo's testimony did nothing to help us. It did nothing to help the prosecution either. It's discredited a key witness. If he forgot all this shit, he could have forgotten seeing another person at the booth. Plus now we don't even know the identity of the waitress who laced the coffee. All we know is what old Mr. Kudo saw, the apron straps and the ribbon, and that the victim was wearing an earpiece when his eardrum was ruptured. Talk about a terrifying case of contradictionists. Time to play doctor and find ourselves the cure then, huh? Yeah! Yeah, we've got to find one for Maggie. We've got to find one for Maggie or she's going to have a terminal case of guilty. Mm-hmm. Alright, talky-talk. What to do? Well, I'm officially at a loss as to where to start. Yeah, me too. Let's try to do some brainstorming. You go first. I guess we should try to put Mr. Kudo's testimony to some sort of use. Yeah, that's true. What we need to do is figure out where he was sat. If we know he definitely broke a vase when he startled, he will probably then show where he was sitting. And we need to figure out the identity of the waitress and who the victim really was. Somehow I think the key to this case is going to be at Trebien. We're gonna have to go back there. Let's go back there and check it out. Oh, and we should drop in on Maggie and see how she's doing too. That'll be the first port call. I need to work myself up to the French accent that I have to do for that other guy. I might tone it down a little bit today. That was hard to keep up. So, anything on your mind? Actually, there is something. I was wondering about Zinehop, you know, like what he's like and stuff. Oh, yeah. I almost forgot about that guy. Fucking Charlie Sheen over here. With his tiger blood. I gotta beat you so hard it'll feel like yous were smooching the express train. Eh. Phoenix Wright? Are you saying yous, Phoenix Wright? Cause I'm Phoenix Wright. I'm the one and only. Sure, dude. We've got a creepy, obsessed stalker fanboy. Actually, I've learned a little something about my doppelganger. Oh, you did? What did you find out? Oh yeah, Maya was working at the restaurant when I ran into Don Frio... Don Fonione. Oh, that's a good one. Don Fonione. Let's just say he was such a terrible vision of me that I wanted to sue for defamation. What's that guy's story, anyway? What does he have to gain by impersonating me? Let's present a bunch of stuff to then. So, the bike. That thing must have been in an accident. It's a total wreck. That's what the guy I met at the park was riding. And I'm betting it's he's the fake me.
Because I'm Phoenix Wright. The one and only.
Voice is still ringing in my ears. Introduce me next time, Nick. I want to meet Zinehop too. Can we talk to her about the food? You know anything about this? Even someone as worldly wise as me doesn't know everything about everything.
You served this to me. You made me pay for it.
So I, the great Maya, am sad to say I can't tell you much about this object. A simple yes or no, Maya. Not as if you have to give me a dissertation. Okay, so the half a million debt that the restaurant is in. Alone for $500,000. I wonder what Mr. Armstrong did to get into that much debt. I'm gonna guess he spent money needlessly. You better watch your spending too. Hey, I've got a great idea. What if Mr. Armstrong charged $20,000 for the Twin T set?
Nobody would buy it.
I don't think you understand how money works, Maya. If you hit people with that kind of bill, Maya, they will hit you back, literally. A letter of apology from the old man. Oh, how sweet. Actually, this is his testimony, if you call it that. So, what's it say? I broke the vase at my seat, I'm sorry. I used to break things all the time when I was little, you know. Still do. And I used to have to write apologies all the time, too. Well, Pearls and Adrian seem to have picked up where you left off. Okay, she doesn't know anything about the autopsy report. The floor plan. Picture. The cup. That's the cup the poison was in, isn't it? Yeah, and the stain on the rim shows the victim used his right hand to pick it up. The old man swore he saw the victim pick it up with his left hand. If Mr. Kudo wasn't mistaken, then what could account for the contradiction? Maybe I should try the lottery sometime too. Sure, why not? If you hit the jackpot, you could win $500,000. So what are we waiting for, Nick? Buy one. No way, you buy one. Don't you know the lottery is a tax on people who are bad at math? Ah, fine then. At least I can add it to my newly renamed Paths to Wealth. I have to call Pearl later and have her add it and buy lottery tickets whenever possible. It's almost surreal that this artsy apron is what got us this far. Well, as art goes, this piece of evidence leaves an impression. I guess that means the old guy never saw the front of it, huh? Which means he didn't see the waitress's face either. I can't believe they found this in Maggie's pocket. Yeah, but she was passed out, right? The killer could have easily planted it on her. How'd you even get hold of something like this? It's not like you can go down to your local Costco and buy it in bulk for $5 a pound. Costco, I like that. He's got a point. How the killer got hold of this poison is pretty important. I'm telling you, it's gonna be What's-Her-Face from the beginning. I forgot her name now, but you know, the Disney princess girl with all the butterflies and shit. The new ear autological clinic, huh? I guess if your eardrum was ruptured, you couldn't listen to the radio, huh? Yeah, it'd be pretty pointless to wear an earpiece of any kind. The medication in the bag is missing too, right? The mysterious vanishing medication, much like our mysterious other person. Here's an idea. So he ruptured his eardrum because he was... Well, it said he was assaulted, but what if he was in an accident, and what if he was hit by this guy's scooter, and they were settling up at the cafe later, and then it turned to murder? That'd be really fucking cool.